Welcome to Sailing with Dave. We're reaching down the lake. We're broad reaching, actually. And welcome to the 360 experience. I'm just going to leave the camera on, and we're going to see what happens as we... Well, the idea is I'm going to broad reach all the way down the lake. I'm always tempted to run and do wing on wing, but it means that my gybing experience is pretty poor. So today we're going to broad reach all the way back. Let me get a time check. I'm not paying attention. Quarter to two. Okay, you've got to drive actually. Let's go. I'm more worried about losing my tack over the side than I am capsizing the boat. As you can see, the jib's really struggling for air. See? So unless we go on a broad reach like that, and then she'll, whoa, you boy, can you feel that? Another thing I'd like is a little cleat on the mainsail, that'd be nice as well. Wow, we are motoring. Just trying to pull the, just realised that my This boat loves to reach. It loves it. I think this is where it comes into its own. We are absolutely motoring. If I could do this all the way around Britain, going round in a few weeks.
Maybe not quite.
Okay, we're gonna jibe, get a little bit closer to the shore over there. Just gonna pull the sail in so there's not too much sail to flap about and cut across. That also means if you've got a boom, that also means, you know, you won't be the boom won't hit you as hard if it hits you. So what we can do is we can aim for the you may be able to see the weather station. We're there already almost. Yeah, we're part of camping already. There's the enchanted forest. This is very nice. It's been a really lovely day today. Getting a little bit too close really, but there we go. It's good to see what's, you know, how well we're going. That's good, isn't it? She's so easy to handle downwind. It's incredible. On the water there, but it's really important to look out for those. Feel the gusts now. You've got a little bit of forewarning that the gust is on its way. You know, you can get yourself ready. You know, on this boat I can see me, you know, tying up the mainsheet quite a bit. But you've just got to be careful, you've got to be forever careful with that. What? Feel the boat settle. When you get the sails right, you kind of feel the boat just works. So now I've just tightened the jib up, I seem to be steering a little bit less, so maybe the mizzen's a little bit overpowered and I was having to steer, I was having to steer against the mizzen, I think, quite a bit. I wanted to just do a boat speed, didn't I? Let's do that quickly. Oh wow, 6.9. 7.1. I leave the boat speed on in my vest, so it doesn't need warming up a lot more. Novice and the layperson, just when I'm doing stuff like this, it just gives you, you know, people understand miles an hour a little bit better. They can feel that speed. When we start doing anything on the water, you know, serious, it's always lots and lots of miles. 6.5 miles an hour there. So we're going much faster than the mirror ever goes. So she obviously hits her whole speed, unless she's planing, of course. Ooh, wow, here's a gust. 6.7. Nice, very nice. So reaching is the way forward. I love that. Right, I don't want to get too close to shore. When you want to jive. But when you're jiving or tacking, especially with tacking, don't worry about coming off your course too much. Worry about, you can over tack or over jive, you'll keep your speed up. And you can then worry about your course and setting your sails like later. Unless you race it, of course, and then you need to get it right. Oh, there's a train again. Take a time at the buoy, which I kind of call our entrance to the harbour, but it's over there. And I think that's, is it B or E or just B? God, I can't remember. But there's also buoy 3, which is the main there. As long as we are there, I think that's where we take a time. And we go only a couple of minutes away now. And it's 2:15. That took us half an hour from right at the bottom of the lake. That's like incredible. That's so fast. Oh, I'm really chuffed because I thought this boat was slow. But I think when you compare it to the new dinghy, it's not that slow. Other than in maybe in light winds where the mirror's weight will just help her. But compared to other boats, she may be a bit slow. But I'll take slow over stable any day of the week with, within mind what I want to do with that. Another big wave. We're going to go almost beam on now. My other camera up. So we're going to go almost beam on. Feel the waves are now hitting the side of the boat. Slightly more uncomfortable. Not a sailing position that a lot of sailors like because it's uncomfortable. Obviously beating when you're if you're doing that for days on it can be pretty tiring. For a day it's exhilarating. We're going wibbly wobbly now. Oi, as the waves pass under us. So when you look over that way, you may not be able to see on this camera, but going to home just yet. This wind is very tasty. We'll do a few more circuits and then we'll see. And I'll try not to fall in this week. In fact, I'll keep the cameras rolling in case I do. But it's not a big deal, to be frank. Just drive myself off. I just spin the boat in. I'd just rather not fall in, to be honest with you. Off that beam reach, we're now still broad reaching. You can tell instantly how it's gone very tame and quiet. We'll just come back onto the broad reach. There you go, so you can feel the wind. Boats love the wind hitting the side. Oh, a bit blustery. Look at these waves coming in. Starting to see the white horses as well on the waves breaking. Right, we're going to do a nice steady drive. I undid the wrong there. Okay, let's do a nice. had enough momentum to get us back out. Sitting further at the boat, get the weight forward.